That was close. I've been to there trying to pass Carlo and I'm almost crashing into him. 1M for pro racing simulation, sorry. They're being passed by the Jota car. Let's see what's what. See if the left timing is working. It is not. Come on. Work with us. Indians used smoke signals, the racing drivers used headlights. That's pretty. I know this is, makes no sense whatsoever. It's what it seems like. Oof, going sideways there. Almost unblocked. Is he braking or lighting his lights up? Martin Vindish from Jamaica Boys. Been having a good race. Been between 6th and 4th. Obviously in the class, not overall. Sikorsky. So the brother Sikorsky, not Lukas Sikorsky, the other one. Daniel Farber. He's been only in the race in GTs. Pretty comfortable, I would say. So 3 Wide Motorsport will have, if anything happen, if nothing happens, sorry, we'll have a overall win and a GT win. So. Traffic jam of LMP2s. Oof! Nordpint almost hitting the wall.
Signal switched.
Sorry, back again. We had to restart the server due to problems about the CTD. We're gonna restart the race and the safety car. We're using the results before the CTD, so the positions that were before the CTD will maintain. And this half an hour of racing that happened is cancelled, pretty much. So nobody will be advantaged by the CTD gain positions and so on and so on. We are just waiting for all the drivers to get in the server. We have pretty much all of them. And we're gonna restart in about 5 minutes. Well, it's a, I don't know if you can call it positive race. Only two bit massive issues with the server. One at 11 and another at 10 in the morning. Almost 11 in the morning, so 12 hours between them. Not as good as we expected, which was only one crash at 2 o'clock in the morning. But life is like this, and we have to be prepared. Somebody is doing safety car. Problem is, I cannot see who it is. See? Manage that. So Black Road Racing safety car. So the Ferrari is back. Remember that last night was the Porsche. Now it's the Ferrari. Ferrari making a comeback from yesterday. With Daniel Gaspar at the wheel, one of the Porsche drivers. So pretty much the same thing, all seen straight, the cars will stop, and I think Daniel is stopped too far back. He should be closer to PlayStation again, by the way. That's the way he decided to stop. They're gonna stop behind, form up, go to the end of the lap, and Daniel will pull up to the pit stops, and Stollinger will have the option to accelerate within the green flag, obviously. So here we go, moving a bit forwards because it's too close to the beginning of Molson Strait. just one of the guys from Jur Racing asking me how is the broadcast going. Good, always. So I was just waiting for this to start. Very good lineup from the LMP1 cars. Extremely good lineup. Whoa, what the hell? How the hell did they manage to do that? Well, they slept, that's for sure. Talking on chair, they are pulling onto the back of the leader of LMP2. Which should be, it was last time, Anthony De Mera, and it is. So James Johnson stopped as well. Smarda from LGPL as well. Check. Juan van Duren from Tour Racing. Ugald, sorry, from the. Wait. From the Argentinian, one of the Argentinian teams. The second Argentinian team is obviously. There, away Tonga Guardia. Michael Omela from IRG World Racing is in the image. Killer Motorsport Marcela Aiello should be arriving soon. Should, we'll see. And there is break. There you go. Marcel Yellow stopping. Don't get too close. There you go. The third Argentinian team. Patron Tequila. That looks like a car that I saw in American Le Mans series. Or the new Tudor series, or whatever it's called. Ricardo Azevedo for Project CR. Darryl Russell for Rush Motorsport. The Brazilian team of Club IV with Malek coming. Rafael Malek pulling back. Oi! Wrong button. Club AV car. Very good livery, I should say. Someone put their hands there on the front of the car. Not very good. Not very nice. Rush Motorsport, the reversal is eager to go. Calm down, my friend. Not going anywhere. But at the moment. The next one will be the GT cars. Daniel Faber, Matthias Palette for Spirit Endurance, Gent Lady. RFDT Racing with Salvatore Carollo. Dennis Gary Murray for Jamaica Boys. Thank you. and Daniel Faber will continue on the Ferrari from Triad Motorsport GT. Palette will replace Virgin. You could get closer to the LMP2 cars, they won't bite. Salvatore Garolo just pulling back as well. With Gary Murray. And Xaba Kiss as well. Ricardo Zuedo having a nudge behind from a Brazilian. Won't be very happy from me saying that. Oh no, wait, is Ricardo letting the Peugeot go? It is. Tap the brakes! A yellow too, letting the car roll back, which is not very good. Silvestre! Getting to the grid from Pro Race Simulation, Canarian team, Richard Burns Rally, good, really good, Rally Sim, good, maintain like that. That's my favorite car, just by that, Richard Burns Rally. Kuba Sikorski as well, stopping Lukasz Vidra as well, and we are missing someone. Oh yeah, we're missing Gil Turazzi and Tarno Selvi, since Tarno Selvi is still in the pits. Turazzi is here.
Just missing Tarno Selvi, which is coming.
LMP2 car there moving forward. Trying to. Sabak is trying to move forward a bit. In front of the GTs. Tarno Selvi coming. And when Tarno Selvi puts his car side by side there with Turazzi, we're ready to go. And we are going. You could see Stollinger go with Daniel Gaspar, the safety car driver as well. And we are getting ready for restart after 9 hours and something without a problem we had to do. 3 hours and 44 minutes to go. The race will end at 2:40. No brakes. cars warming up the tires. Waving one thing and the other. Usual stuff, safety car with lights on. Still. Indianapolis, wait, Arnash, Nuno Pinto as well, trying to put some heat, braking. Get ready. This is gonna start like hell. Judging by the way Stollinger is, one of my episodes is gonna do like he did. His teammate did last night. And he's just gonna try to create a gap. So here we go. Hopefully nobody will. We'll crash. We'll see. And we are racing behind them. Everything is okay. We are racing green flag. And I think Nuno Pinto jumped there to start, but being a restart. Yeah, he left Stollinger to his own. Tagli. Passing by Nuno Pinto. Obviously this is, they are fighting and racing, but the positions were one more lap to Stollinger, so they have to unlap themselves in order to fight with the leader. Plus Tagli and Nuno Pinto have one more lap between them, so Tagli unlapping himself from Nuno Pinto. Or from the last time I saw the live timing working properly, it was. Further back, the GTs started okay. All of them. Yep, all of them. First time that the GTs start okay. LMP2. Oh, battle and the crash there. Rush Motorsport.
Está dois.
And the leader of the... no, it's not. Yeah, Ricardo Azevedo and then Russell. Then who it was? Oh, okay. The Russell brake. Ugalo take a bit longer to brake and collected him. On braking zone for PlayStation chicane. The Russell. There. Not having a very good second chicane as well. Dear God, this car is. What happens? He breaks. Oh yeah. Bang. That's it. Oof. big crash. Massive crash for Derek Russell. He comes to the pits, can't help to get penalty for Derek Russell. As for... oh, the LMP1, Spruza, yeah, Juan Spruza almost... Jan Spruza, sorry. Almost spinning on Arnaud. Anthony De Meira, the leader of LMP2s with a lead of 2 laps, is just strolling around. Watching the fight between Ricardo Zweden and Juan van Duren, which they, I don't know if they were fighting for position before. Juan van Duren, a very competent driver, as well as Ricardo, but Juan is very experienced in endurance. Ricardo trying in the... almost trying to the inside of chicane, of the Dunlop chicane, but not having any luck whatsoever. The speed difference on the exit of the corners is mind-blowing. Petrol car versus a diesel car. And now he goes. Ricardo Zweden going. There he is, sticks it. And away we go. Somebody lost the front wing, the front bumper, which was Mr. Nuno Pinto. Attacking Stollinger, brakes too late. Oh, yeah. Bang! Schoenberg passing by him and Tagli. Schoenberg, no, Adam Williams, sorry. So I'm up into losing time now. Massive jump from Nuno Pinto without the front bonnet or front wing if you want. Stollinger meanwhile doing his race, one lap advantage, so no problem with that. And the GT's Garimere is being pressured by Lucas Vidra and Turazzi. Vidra going wide there on Arnaud. Being passed by Turazzi. Trying to get the slipstream right away. Waving one way or the other. Won't help your sure. Great exit from Indianapolis, and it's got a... What the hell was that? Don't know. Going wide on Arnage, not helping the speed on the exit. I knew I was hearing something strange, hearing Radio Le Mans broadcast from some race. So, Le Vidra trying to pass Turazzi, sorry, from B6 on GTs, not having very luck. It's a bit strange because it's GT2 and nobody took the BMW and the Spanos and the Spiker, so we get a bit just Ferraris and Porsches, which for some people is not the best combination. Then again, they have been having one hell of a race, that's for sure. GT1's obviously too fast for these GT2s, as Tanner Selvi loses a position or loses a lap for Gary Murray. Carolo. Salvatore Carolo not being very happy on this race or this racetrack. He didn't manage to maintain the advantage that his teammate Riccardo Corazzari built, and he's been losing speed all along. Not a very good perspective for the end of the race. Matthias Palet, second on the GTs. Got, last time I checked, one more lap than Daniel Faba. So he's got one lap himself and get into the truck again of Daniel Faba to fight for a position. This Ferrari is having an immaculate race until now. A We'll see how this will turn up to be at the end of the race. We have more 3 hours and 28 minutes to go. Ricardo Azevedo posing the first sector of the race, or at least this session. Tunga Guardia fighting with Omela for P5, sorry, on the LMP2s. On board with Tonga. Fuel reset. Click that. And you're sure to be one hell of a ride. Car will restart, that's for sure. Great exit from Dunlop chicane there. Very good panel, light on and off, two options.
Fuel pump.
Is that main pump or rain SEO? Don't know what that means. Ignition, starter, start. Why does he need so many things for start? ECU, PDU, PDU again, that's the results. Fuel from dear lord, I'm gonna be passing by. Oh, almost touching each other. Great work there from Tonga. Oh, whoa, Tonga spinning. Reverse. First, hitting the wall again. Ugal, they're almost spinning as well. He lost it completely on the way into Molson corner. Sabakis there. Oh, Pinto crashing into Thunder Selby. Oh, a big crash. Thunder Selby flew off. Completely. What the hell happened? Dear God, that was a big crash and Thunder Selby went flying. So Thunder Selby back to the pits. As well. Dear Lord, that's a bit with Thunder Selby as well. Sparta. Without being watching Zmarda that much, but he is in second at the moment. Sorry, third at the moment on the LMP2s. On board with the Rakura, and I'm gonna shut up and let you guys enjoy. Hold up. With ZNX Marta from Team RGPL Czech. No, I didn't die. I just been checking a level, as always. Well, back to the commentary booth.
How you going?
For a while. Traffic jam from prototypes. Carlos Vedo using his superior car to just weave around the slower traffic. And if you think these two are fighting for position, well, they are fighting for virtual second place. Stalling there, exiting Arnage. Go on board with Chenberg for a couple of laps while I do. I finish my background checks on life timing and other things. Anyway. So back momentarily to say that Nurupito had a drive-thru. After Nuno Pinto, Solingar is in the pits, pitting for his first time since the restart. Daniel Faber there trying having to get away from Nuno Pinto, otherwise Nuno Pinto will stick with him. Drive through then for Nuno Pinto, due to that crash, because of that crash that he's had with Tanner Selby. Oh, whoa, Nuno Pinto almost losing the car. Touching the wheel, touching the grass, and yeah, that's what happens. So, drive through. For Nuno Pinto almost crashing into the wall there on the pit stop. You can see Stollinger there. On the pitch, Nuno Pinto was gone. So, drive-thru completed. That, I mean, Le Mans drive-thru doesn't penalize that much because the racetrack is so big. But still, 20 seconds lost there. Just to a drive-thru. Back on board with Nuno Pinto, I'm gonna try to finish my background thingy I'm doing, and I'll be right back. So 3 hours to go. Thereabouts. Plus a couple of seconds. 3 hours to go. Racing is okay-ish at the moment. Obviously, with all the laps differences between the guys, it's quite hard to know who he's fighting with. Another Pinto there locking up on the Indianapolis. Oh, what happened to you, my friend? Indianapolis crash? Yes. Failed the braking. Oh yeah, you're not going anywhere. Dimar GPL, LMP1. Losing the front wing. Marius Bert is inside of the leader car. At least I think it is, leader car. On board with Marius. Tanner Selvey right in front! Don't crash into him, there you go. Really close to the wall. Five kph, I think it's the max. 336. Oh, almost losing the brakes there. Slipstream. Oh yeah, LMP2 cars break quite early, don't they? And this is a Peugeot. Oh, they break early. That...
quite early on the brakes.
Really hard on the brakes for Molson corner. Away you go, hard on the power. Almost losing the car under the braking. There on the Indianapolis, you can see that right hander is flat out. It's just, you don't take the foot there. Oh, Arnaz going a bit wide. Well, you don't take the foot there on LMP1 or LMP2. GT, you have to, otherwise you're going to end up in the wall. Sabaki is entering the baits. Mario is not entering. Woof! Getting a lot of curves there. Well, he jumped the curves, he didn't make the curve. Jumped the curves and almost having an effect there on the exit. Ricardo asking me if I'm okay. Yeah, yeah, I'm okay. No problem with that. Why do I think that means something else? Anyway, moving on. Marius Bert, still on board with Marius. Still driving like a madman. So Ricardo will enter on the Peugeot of Lusitanium for in about 10 minutes. There's 1 hour and 10, 1 hour and a half. And then Marius Bert will enter the car for the final 1 hour and a half. Okay. Ricardo saying that, well, it's better than to say. Anyway, moving on. Marius Bert there. Ricardo Azevedo coming out of the pits after a stop. Schedule stop, that is. Forgot to see how much is the damage on this race. I think it's 50. So, where is that? Traffic jam behind Tanner Selvi and a lot of cars, GT cars on the pits as well. Schindberg coming to pass those. Daniel Faber, oh, holy moly. Braking really late there and locking up the tires. So Daniel Faber driving to win the GTs, that's for sure. I think nobody will challenge Daniel till the end of the race. Which means one hell of a win for 3 Wide Motorsport as a team, LMP1 and GTs. Maybe they could find an LMP2 car and probably they would win that as well. Oh, going sideways there. Still going sideways. At what I call a rally driver corner. Scandy flick, to be precise. One way to the other. Oh, cutting the corner there. Don't love chicane, the first one is left. I still have the stick shift, not like the 458 that has the pedal shifter. So doesn't matter because in F-Factor everyone knows, uses pedals, but you can see this car still has the stick shifter instead of the pedal shift that the younger brother has. Well, brother is a son or something. If you follow Ferrari, you'll know what I'm talking about. If you don't, go search. To the mirror, meanwhile, on virtual leaderboard is second after the pits. After, obviously, he has the pits. And I think Daniel Faber as well has the pit. Yep, Daniel Faber has the pit. He's got an advantage, well, at least on this one, from to Matthias Palet of 32 seconds on this leaderboard, obviously. Remember, this is not the real one. I remember watching these guys and they having one more lap than Matthias Palin, so. A break. I don't drive a GT car for quite a long time, but I know he has to break there. Oh, I think the car going a bit sideways. Not on this lap that this comes for a pit stop, so I have to wait for a bit. Yeah, that's dangerous to do. Climb that second curb, getting the car all nervous on the exit and too much spinning. That happened on the restart last night with a Porsche from Roush Motorsport. Back the cars, we have 27 cars yet, so really good. Nuno Pinto meanwhile will change to Ricardo Ferreira. We'll see how that turns up. Nuno Pinto attacking, as you can see.
was moved to your
Yes,
cabin.
You can. We have with me one of the team boss, or team owner, actually. A team owner. From
Good
Lucid
morning.
Enemy. Calm down.
Bon dia.
Team owner from Lucid MSR, Flip Branco. Flip! You, oof! Nope into that. Close to that Tetrarouge tires. Flip, you guys have been racing this for the first time. 24 hour race, I think, as a team. How is the balance?
Well, if I speak Portuguese, it's better.
Oh, you can speak Portuguese.
Yeah? Okay. Okay. Bom, para já os meus parabéns a esta corrida. Acho que está a correr muito bem. Acho que está a correr muito bem. Tenho que dar os meus parabéns, portanto, à organização. Peço desculpa, mas estava aqui a ouvir o feedback da reportagem.
Tens de desligar.
Já está. Não, acho que está a correr muito bem. Daquilo que eu vi ontem, tive com o pessoal um bocado a ver a corrida, acho que está muito bem. Bem, parabéns também pelo pessoal que apareceu por aí. Acho que equilibrou bastante as corridas. Com alguma pena minha, não consegui participar tanto nestas 24 horas por falta de tempo para me adaptar aos carros e treinar, etc, etc. Porque agora estou com bastante pena de não poder, ao ver aqui este pessoal todo a correr.
Just to say, I'm going to translate everything that he says to English. We're just going to carry on speaking Portuguese. It's easier for both of us. Well, depends. I'm from Madeira, so my accent not only is not that easy to understand for some mainland guys. But anyway. Mas eu perguntei-te no início sobre o balanço da equipa. Achas que foi bom a equipa? Ou os pilotos que vocês foram buscar não saíram... Ser um tiro pela culatra, como se costuma dizer.
Não, eu acho que não. Acho que foi bastante equilibrado as equipas. Pronto, tivemos muitos azares, pelo que eu tive a falar com os pilotos. Pronto, azares de percurso, digamos assim, de corridas. Alguma falta de corridas de alguns outros pilotos, de estarem a participar com outros pilotos, portanto as aberturas, as passagens, digamos, entre aspas, a obediência dos sinais de luzes, portanto isso dá umas batidas, uns toques, uns choques e tal, mas acho que foi uma equipa bem escolhida e acho que estão-se a portar muito bem.
Exato. Basicamente, vocês foram buscar uma equipa de Fórmula 1, que é basicamente a equipa. São tudo pilotos que vêm da Fórmula 1.
Exatamente.
E conseguiram montar uma equipa que de momento está em segundo. Vamos lá ver até o final, obviamente.
Penso que vai correr tudo bem. Penso que vai... Eu acho que a experiência na Fórmula 1 para estes modos e para estas corridas de 24 horas... É espelho, é um espelho autêntico, não é?
Sim. Pá, se alguns puristas já irão dizer que corridas de pilotos de Fórmula 1 não se dão muito bem com endurance, achas que isso é assim? Ou o Nuno, o Ricardo e o. Especialmente o Marco, que o Marco é o piloto de Fórmula 1, que até agora tinha corrido só em Fórmula 1, achas que. Mostrou isso, que os pilotos de Fórmula 1, mesmo no virtual, dão-se mal com tanto tráfego?
Eu acho que não, demonstra a corrida, está a demonstrar portanto, a consistência em corrida e toda a experiência que se adquire na Fórmula 1, da consistência das voltas a volta, do manter sempre o mesmo tempo. Aqui, a minha opinião é, portanto, eu acho que a consistência não é o mais importante, mas sim o rodar em pista precavendo-se de alguns pilotos nas dobragens, e eu acho que isto é o que faz chegar ao fim, portanto, em bem posicionado. Mas eu acho que sim, que a Fórmula 1 acho que ensina muito, e depois e vir para aqui fazer corridas de endurance é um complemento, digamos assim.
Pois, oh, Nuno Pinto spinning on Indianapolis. You could see that one coming, the way he did the right-hander. Continuing with interviewing Felipe, in Portuguese,
pois,
obviously.
Aqui um chatzinho do Nuno.
É, a maneira como ele fez a direita.
Penso que vai brevemente entrar nas boxes. Eu agora estive aqui um break.
Sim. Portanto, a experiência da Fórmula 1 ajuda. Vocês iam ter uma segunda equipa, se bem sei, nos GTs. O que é que aconteceu?
Bom, essa equipa nos GTs seria eu e mais alguns pilotos da Lusitânia. Pronto, só que não foi avante. Decidimos não ir, decidimos só apostar nesta equipa forte, com estes três pilotos. E pronto, abdicámos dos GTs para nos empenharmos no LMP. Portanto, basicamente foi isso. Provavelmente para o ano, se este projeto continuar, iremos com mais equipas. Agora, seja LMP ou seja, portanto, GTs, etc, etc, não sei. Ao longo do ano vamos fazer esse projeto e depois logo veremos.
Certo. Pois, vamos lá ver. Eu acabei por, quando comecei a comentar a corrida e comecei a ver que isto ia ser o que era, acabei por me arrepender em não ter o volante pronto.
Pois, começa a mexer o bichinho, não é?
Começa a mexer um tecido bichinho de endurance. Mas pronto, o meu trabalho é comentar, não é correr. Diga-se de passagem que eu também em pista não sou lá muito grande pistola.
É pá, mas dás uma volta e outra e outra e outra e assim sucessivamente, não é?
Tenho que treinar. Não, eu tinha que ficar. Estes gajos treinam uma semana e estão prontos a correr. Eu tinha que treinar um mês. Vendo as rallies é um tecido mais difícil. Se bem que a parte do ser regular, nós aprendemos isso logo, mas em termos de andamento, de velocidade pura, pilotos de Fórmula 1, esses então são especialistas nessa parte. Para nós, tráfego é um problema, para eles, exato. Nem tanto.
Não. Temos então o Ferreira em pista, tanto que vai fazer mais este stint e depois vai trocar. Há aqui algum problema com o carro, pelo que eu estou a ver.
Ah, é lag.
É lag, ok. Okay. Portanto, ele vai fazer este hora e meia mais ou menos, e depois teremos um outro piloto final a fazer o final da corrida.
Yeah, someone there losing a wheel. You can see a wheel there. I was gonna say that, Ricardo missing the PlayStation chicane. Whoa, don't go there. And this buttons. Crap. That's a big mistake for Ricardo Ferreira. Daniel Faber passing. The Krajcik pass as well. I was gonna say, I have to translate everything that Philippe said. Which will be kind of hard to say. But basically he said that he wants to congratulate everyone, the team that organized. That's Hugo, Flip, and all the other guys, Anti, Virgin, Nuno Pinto, all the marshals and the admins that put this project together. The other things is, you want to continue next year, the project, right? I think he did that. He said as well that he hopes that this project stays on for next year. We'll see. Next year, talking on team-wise, Lusitanium will bring more cars. This year they couldn't bring the GT car, which was for Philippe himself and a couple of the other drivers, Ricardo Ferreira Hilário Sousa, Nuno Gonçalves and Ignacio Freitas. If you follow the Clios, you will know who I'm talking about. Ignacio Freitas as well. He's a new driver for Lusitania. Hilario is well known in the business. Nuno as well. Even though Nuno is more for the rally than racing, still works the same way. And we've been talking about the difference between an F1 driver and endurance driving. So he said that it's not that different. In F1, obviously you learn to be quick and maintain a regular pace, making laps after lap. And here is basically the same. And then we compare to my experience in rally. I can be regular, but I cannot be fast always. And obviously, for me, it would have to take probably 1 month to get to grip with the quickness of these guys. For them, it's 1 week training, and they are pretty much on the spot. Other things that he said is the problems with the traffic. Obviously, going around traffic is always a big issue. Then again, the drivers have to get used to. He said that most of the Lusitanian drivers have a problem with traffic, going around traffic and light signal, because they're not used to do light signals. And you could see that with Ricardo Ferreira there on the Dunlop chicanes, trying to get himself around the RGPL LMP1 car, which will do if they don't crash into each other. No, managed to do into the inside of Tatra Roche, the first corner of the complex of Tatra Roche. But Flip there doing pretty much all sum up about the Lusitania MSR race, which was good, apart from some mistakes and some bad luck during the night with one puncture and two failed pit stops, which I think Ricardo said they lost 40 seconds in each of them. So 40 seconds in Le Mans is already a lot. You lose half a lap on that. So very bad luck for the Lusitanian boys, even though they have been racing and they are in second place at the moment. Not that bad, after all. Hugo wanted me to announce that 7th of June this year, so June 7, we're gonna have the round 4 of the championship, which is the 1,000 kilometers of Spa, and I hope you guys to be there. It will be over 1,000 kilometers, so that's what, 8 hours, about 8 hours of racing in Spa, Francorchamps. The Belgian circuit will receive the fourth round of the World Endurance Championship organized by Extreme RPM. Picking up the line from Flip, from you guys that are watching, do you want this race to repeat itself next year? Obviously without the problem, server problems, because we were expecting one server problem or two during the night, especially at 2 o'clock in the morning. We had two problems until now. We had one at 11 p.m. in the night, and one at 10 a.m. in the morning. So not as bad as we thought it would be, but then again, it's always a bit of a problem to get grips too. Go to Facebook or Twitter, comment and make your opinion on how this race went. We have 2 hours and a couple of minutes to go, and write your thoughts on what should be the next year race, and which teams will be here for next year as well. Lusitanium will be. Apparently Philippe said that if the project maintains, the Lusitanium will have various cars in various categories, so that's good. Ben Will is saying definitely repeat it. That's good. Flip, Já estás aí, não morreste?
Estou, claro, não. Estou a ver a transmissão.
Exato. Disseste que isto podia se repetir para o ano. Aqueles dois problemas com o server. Nós sabíamos que íamos ter um problema, pelo menos um, às 2 e tal da manhã. Mas eu estou a ficar rouco, não sei porquê. Mas aqueles dois problemas não desmotivam?
Não, acho que não. Nada mesmo, nada mesmo. Acho que está aqui a prova de um grande trabalho de toda a organização deste evento. E acho que não é por causa desses dois crash ou dois bugs, ou chamem-lhe o que quiserem, que vá desmotivar o continuar tanto deste projeto. E falavas há pouco nas 1000 horas de SPA, este que era com o handset, correto?
Seis, enfim, acho que 6 ou 7 já mesmo.
Junho, não é?
Sim.
Pronto. Pode ser uma outra prova que dê para testar outras soluções de server, digamos assim. Mas não sei, mas acho que em suma acho que temos que dar os parabéns a todo este esforço. Não é por causa desses dois bugs, digamos assim, que vamos perder o ânimo de continuar.
Pois é, primeira paragem foi um pouco mais longa do que a segunda. Tivemos que inventar ali um novo QDB para a corrida, para começar a noite, mas... Pronto, é aquelas coisas, são paragens que acontecem durante a corrida. Nós sabemos que todas as comunidades têm problemas, especialmente em 24 horas, porque corridas 24 horas, porque a memória do computador só consegue aguentar até certo ponto. Obviamente não vai, se tens memória de 4, não vais conseguir ter uma performance muito grande. Se o jogo te comer 3 GB de RAM, vai-te mandar a máquina abaixo, basicamente. Nós sabemos que isso iria acontecer às 2 e tal da manhã, mas não estávamos à espera que isso acontecesse às 11 da noite, o que acabou por acontecer, e tivemos que mudar aquilo tudo e fazer tudo. O que não significa que se acontecesse só uma paragem às 2 e tal da manhã, a gente não ia parar durante uma hora só para resolver aquilo. Não, não,
claro.
Não significa isso. Agora... não sei. Algumas pessoas podem ter ficado assim chocadas com o tempo que nós demorámos a resolver. Diga-se de passagem que tentamos ser sempre o mais rápido possível, mas nem sempre é possível resolver as coisas.
Eu acho que o exemplo está nos números pilotos que ficaram. Portanto, quem estava a correr durante até acontecer o bug e no reiniciar, provavelmente se o pessoal tivesse um bocado desiludido tinha ido embora. E eu acho que a prova foi os pilotos continuarem em pista.
Pois, tínhamos 30 pilotos na altura, ficaram com 30, não é mesmo? Mudaram, algumas equipas mudaram de pilotos, obviamente.
Exatamente.
É sempre uma oportunidade para mudar. O segundo CTD, ou o segundo crash, o segundo restart que nós tivemos, aconteceu a mesma coisa. Pilotos, houve equipas que trocaram de pilotos, e muito bem, porque descansar pilotos é a maneira mais fácil de resolver o problema e não haver chatices.
Claro, claro, claro. Podemos agora ver um bocado dos GTs.
Sim, é dia 7 de junho.
Portanto, nos GTs temos quem à frente?
Temos o Daniel Faber para a Tribal Motorsport. Just to say, I have to translate the first thing again. Just asking if the problems with the server crashes, which we had too. Well, we had one server crash and one CTD, massive CTD, to everyone, pretty much. And we were asking if that doesn't dismotivate anyone, and Philip said no. That's the proof is the amount of drivers that stayed on the server, that's good. 27 drivers still on track. The same 27 that started, well, even though we had 30 drivers on start, three teams have didn't finish or won't finish, and that's bad. Ben sent me a message that Drag is fighting with RGPL P2, I think. So apparently the P2 are very good. Oh, Ogald, very messy there. So where is? Okay, there it is. So yes, it is Team RGPL Czech fighting with Mr. James Johnson from Drag for the second position on LMP2. Basically. And the British team trying to get a second position. They've been leading the race since, well, they led the race on the beginning of the race, on the first 3 hours, I think. But then engineering just went mad and started to lead the race, and they are leading the race since then, basically, in the LMP2s. I had to interview Joran Speck, which is a strategic engineer for Jer Racing, and I have to pull him down, I think, because I don't think he has permission to come in. I have to pull him down. So, Joran, are you there?
Obviously. Yeah, I'm here.
There you go. You are an engineer for Jury Racing, which means you are a driver that today is not driving.
No, that's correct.
How is the race going for Jury Racing?
It's fairly good at the moment. It's not going as planned. We had two crashes and we're still dealing with damage at the current in the current car. We're losing a bit of top speed, but it's not hurting our times that much. So we're just going to continue the race till the end.
Yeah. You guys have been second in petrols and LMP1's cars for the entire race, pretty much. Did you guys thought that you guys could win the petrol cars at least at the end of the race? On the beginning, I was it?
We never really thought about winning. We were just competing for the race itself, seeing how it goes. We have, I believe, two new drivers with us this year, and next year we'll be running two teams because I'll be running next year as well, and we will have seven drivers. So that means we can put up two teams. And this year is just an old united effort from everyone who know about the different leagues coming together and starting a new team. And
I was actually going to ask, how did it born, the Jer Racing project? Because I know Juan van Duren and some of the other guys are from Team Hawk Racing. Or were from Team Hawk Racing.
Yeah, Jer Racing is our four guys. It's Johan, Eddie, Rudy, and Ronnie. Those are the first letters of their names into the team name. And they basically started it off. They started racing. I believe they were here last year under a different name. And then this year it expanded and we got more people in it. And that's how it happened.
Yeah. Very good team then.
Yeah, it's a bit fairly even. We have three or four fairly fast drivers and then two or three not so fast drivers, but still competitive enough to be in the team.
Yeah, that's always good to have drivers that are not as fast as the really fast ones, but still very competitive and still very regular drivers, which it's important in a 24-hour race. Another question, did you guys during the night had problems with traffic?
I'm gonna ask the team over chat because I wasn't fully here this night. I did know we had a server crash about 11 p.m. which really influenced the strategics and the times and the fueling pit stops and how it was gonna run, so we had to redo the strategy a bit, but other than that we're not really in much trouble.
Okay, while you ask your team about that, I'm gonna have a hint, because someone within XNRPM, and that's not me, I'm admin on XNRPM, but I didn't know about this, and I'm knowing now. It's being prepared at an Endurance Master Series on American tracks with the 24 hours of Daytona, what the hell, anyway. And with a champion, with a support championship in Asia. So, two championships for the price of one. So apparently, this endurance championship, is being so big that some guys on Extreme RPM are thinking on having two more in from August to December. This year, that's being brave. So there you go. It's an int. You're gonna have an American Le Mans Series kind of thing, only with American tracks, and a support championship on Asian tracks. All get confused, but you guys will know something in a short time. I'm gonna ask for explanation. That's for sure.
Yeah, I believe due to the nature of the team, we're probably going to join everything we can. It's just how we are. We love racing, and that's why we do it. We're also in a few different leagues on different websites. I believe we're on simracing.nl as well. Those are GT races with R-Factor. There's another endurance race on R-Factor 2, which we're in. So we do have a lot of races over the entire year. And coming back on your question about the night, we didn't really have any problems apparently, it just went very smooth, apart from the server crash then.
Yeah, so the traffic wasn't a problem then for you?
No, the traffic was alright, I think they moved over fairly smoothly.
Trying to get the explanation about that taint, but it's getting harder and harder to get. Nobody talks with me, I'm an admin, fucking admin.
That's what you get for being an admin.
Yeah, and being commentating as well, which... Oh, I see. Now I know. The championship will be called Endurance Master Series. And we'll have American tracks, and then we'll have a support mini championship in Asia. There you go. This is the explanation that I received now from a man that is slow at work, and it's slow at explaining things as well. So you know who it is. Who he is.
I've just I didn't join the team last week. I'm fairly long with the team, but I'm only a week into the endurance racing on extreme racing for extreme RPM. I have no idea about the people who race here.
No, it's not about the people who are racing, it's about the people that he's organizing.
I have no idea who those are, people are. We race and that's what we do.
Yeah. Well, people that organize it are Hugo Nobre is the endurance director, pretty much. It's the designation. It's to be the